I am State Representative Elizabeth Fiedler, and I proudly represent the 184th District in Philadelphia. Thank you to the Pennsylvania Policy Center, Mark, and your team for inviting me to help kick off this campaign for tax justice. On my walk here through the Capitol, every time someone said, "Hi, how are you?" I said, "I'm on my way to an event about tax justice. You should come." Now, as you heard from Mark and from Senator Haywood, we're here today because there are a lot of complicated problems that we need to solve in state government, a lot of them. But the good news coming out of this presser is that making our tax system more fair is actually pretty straightforward. As you heard, in Pennsylvania right now, taxes are too high for most working and poor people, and taxes are unfairly low for the very richest people. Whether you call them the super rich, the ultra rich, the very, very, very rich. In fact, only Florida, Washington, and Tennessee have tax systems that are less fair than ours. And I do not want to rank behind Florida. It's not a mystery why we rank so poorly, and I'll be brief because you've heard. In Pennsylvania, our flat income tax and our lack of taxation on big corporations mean that low and middle income people and poor people have to pay more. In fact, they have to give a big chunk of their income to state and local taxes, about 11 to 15%. Meanwhile, the super rich, the ultra rich, the very, very, very rich, who make more than $700,000 a year, pay only a small fraction. I was talking with my six-year-old about this, and even my six-year-old agreed that it's not fair if someone has a tiny pie and has to give a big piece of it up, compared to a person with a huge pie only giving a little. No millionaire or billionaire should pay a lower tax rate than a nurse or waitress. You've heard it here today, and we've also heard it from President Biden. It's clearly not fair and not just. And this injustice has consequences for all of our families. This system is upside down, as the senator said. This system means that despite what looks like a strong economy to lots of economists, we know on the ground that ordinary people are struggling under a mountain of bills. Bills they can't afford to pay, grocery bills, utility bills, medical debt, education debt. I believe it was referred to as family education debt, childcare, rent. But there are things we can do and are already doing. In December, we Democrats pushed for and passed a huge expansion of the child and dependent care tax credit as part of the budget. It builds on the federal dependent care tax credit. So now, the state of Pennsylvania matches 100% of the federal credit, not just 30%. So that means that if your family has an income of about $40,000 a year, you have two children, the state match goes from $396 to $1,320. Just about every family I know would say it's a pretty big deal to add almost $1,000 back in your pocket. This is good news, and I know that my colleagues and I are very proud of this legislation. But of course, we're here today because we want to go further. Instead of governing with austerity, it's time for us to fully fund the public services all of us count on by ensuring the rich pay their fair share. That means the fair share tax plan, repealing the uniformity clause, combined reporting, and so much more. For too long in Pennsylvania, the rich have paid too little in taxes, while the working class and poor people have paid too much. It's the folks in that latter category, the working class and poor people in our districts, who come into our district offices most often, and who I know we hear directly from. It's incumbent upon us as state representatives and state lawmakers to address this injustice. I'm glad to be here today, and I believe in time we will achieve tax justice.